A family tussle is brewing at the home of the opposition leader Raila Odinga over property, a matter that has now pushed the duo into a legal battle. The family feud is between Raila Odinga's wife Ida Odinga, daughter Winnie Odinga, and the widow to Raila Odinga's son Fidel Odinga's widow Lwambekele over the ownership of twins. The family is embroiled in a dispute after the Odingas accused Lwam of sidelining the twins that Fidel Odinga sired with another woman. However, Lwam says she does not recognize the twins as children to Fidel Odinga. According to Lwam, is that her son is the only heir to the deceased estate. Ida Odinga and Winnie Odinga hold that Lwam is aware of the two children, but she has chosen to sideline them. And during the ruling delivered by Justice Agre Muchelule, the twins will now be subjected to a DNA test to confirm their paternity.
Of any blood or tissues or parts of DNA, then the last thing would be that who is going to perform DNA?
The parties including Fidel's widow Lwambekele, his mother Ida Odinga and sister Winnie Odinga were asked to decide where the test will be conducted. Ida Odinga and Winnie Odinga have also accused Lwam of withdrawing her son with Fidel from formal schooling and denying them access to the child. Still in the corridors of justice, Third Way Alliance party leader Ikura Okot suffered another major blow after their case challenging the Building Bridges Initiative BBI failed to kick off with Justice William Korir recusing himself from the case.
Asking the petitioner hearing to file an application for my recusal will amount to a waste of time. In order not to delay the hearing of this petition, I recuse myself.
I think we are probably chasing the wind here. Maybe this is just an academic exercise, and maybe that is the intention eventually to make this very academic exercise, because it doesn't make sense to me that three judges, senior in legal practice, and will say that 10 months later this case raises serious constitutional issues. Let's hear them on priority basis. I think that
Ikura Okot, who filed an application a year ago, faulted the judiciary for failing to listen to the case, which is of great public concern.
It shouldn't be rocket science. There is obvious bias. Third Way Alliance brought a case here against BBI last year. Third Way Alliance, and we asked for even temporary orders. We were not given, not even 7 days, not even 3 days. But Punguza Mizigo was sued in this very, very court before the very, very judges, and adverse orders were given to stop the 47 county assemblies. So you tell me, unless you are completely dumb, there's definitely political interference.
The court case comes at a time when the Building Bridges report is also expected to be out, since the team promised President Uhuru Kenyatta that the report will be out by the end of October. Ikura Okot filed the case seeking for the disbandment of the BBI with claims it's unconstitutional. Reporting for Ebro TV, I'm Jeff Khaemba.